Welcome back to this channel. It is me, Mr. Frederick, once again, here to do a tutorial on how to make assignments on quizzes and give them to your students. Okay? We're going to dive into that step by step how to do it. So let's begin by first starting off with this webpage. You will start up here and you'll want to type quiz.com. And you'll see this page. I recommend that you, if you don't have a quiz account, that you sign up here and log in with the email of your school. Okay? Since I have already created one, I'm going to just go log in. Alright? So you here, you click here, continue with Google. I'll pick the school, McKinney. Whatever your school is, I'll pick that. You put your password in. And boom, you're going to be inside. Okay, so now we're here. So once you have that in motion, you're going to pick a topic based on your subject. So for example, if I'm going to be talking about magnetism, for example, for science. I'll type in magnetism here in the top bar where it's explore. Let me show that again. You press explore, then you go on the top and you put magnetism, you type it in, and then they're going to give you various topics on magnetism. Okay, so looking down here, and you go and pick one that you like. So for example, this looks interesting, so I'll go and pick that. Next off, if I like this quiz, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy it and edit it. You press that. So now I'm gonna put my own touch on it. So I see magnetism, I change the title, magnetism, part one of two. And you make sure you put the grade that you wanna put. So I'm gonna put like sixth grade, for example. You can put any grade you want, 6th to 8th. Press save. And then I look at the questions, and if I like them, so this look good. If there's a question that doesn't correlate with the lesson that you're doing, you could delete it. So for example, I would delete this one, and boom, it's gone. Then, if you want to add more questions, there's two options. You could create a question from scratch where you have to type in the question and type in the answers and choose place one as green to indicate that that's the correct answer. Or, which I recommend for everybody, if you press for time and you just want to quiz quickly, you could teleport questions based on this topic. So if it's in magnetism, when I'm going to go search for it, it opens up this page here. And then it gives me all types of other questions that has the same topic at mind. So for example, I'm going to look at magnetism review. I'm going to pick that. And I look down and I see, oh, this looks good. There's this button here in the corner that says add. So you press it so you can add it. Okay. And boom, it's right here already. Okay. I go down. I see another question I like. I press add. Sometimes you could go leaping from other questions here. If you only could find two or three in there, and you could jump to another one, and then you'll find more questions that you like that's interested. Oh, this is good. You add that. Okay. Once you're done, you're going to notice that the questions that I had, I only had 12. I deleted one, which was 11, and I added three more. So now I got 14. You see? If I'm satisfied with that, I'll press over here, publish. And then I'm done with that one for now. But we still have things to do. You want to assign this as a homework, asynchronous learning. Here is to start a live quiz where you right there, you teaching them, guiding them on Zoom, Microsoft Teams, or Google Meets, or any other platform that contacts students online remotely. You will do this. But if you want to assign them a homework where they could do it on their own pace, for a specific time limit, you would pick this. So I would pick this, assign homework. This is what it'll look like. You have to put a deadline. When do you want this to close? Okay. So if you have the basic account, you have a limited amount of time. So the light, so like in this case, the most I could, the latest I could have the deadline is the 17th. But when you upgrade account, you could do it as, you could put it as late as you want. But for this purposes, I'm gonna put the 10th. The 10th around 5 p.m. Okay. I go down. I'm gonna assign this just to the sixth grade. Boom, boom. Put a title. Magnetism, one of two, for example. Then you go down here and you pick a date. When do you want this to start? So I could start this tomorrow. Put it 7:30 in the morning. Then I'll press next. Okay. So I have the deadline, which is May 10th, but it's going to start May 4th tomorrow. Okay. I already assigned the classes I'm going to do. That's gonna see this assignment. And you go down, you leave this unlimited so they can have a lot of time to do it. Something to show them the answer so they could check the answers, how they got it right. I'll turn off the time off. It's for them to master the material. Okay? And I will leave the rest of these on. Shuffle questions, very important. It ensures that the question that they have is not the same question that the student next to them has. Sometimes they like to try to copy each other. So then also shuffle the answers around. So it's like, oh, I pick A, and I pick the same A, but it's not the same answer. So interesting stuff to consider. I will leave that random. And once you check everything is fine, which I put everything here, then I press assign in the bottom. Then this will show up, and then you're gonna press the two words here, click here in purple. So that they can see this code and you will be able, they'll be able to see it in their Google Classroom. Okay? So that's about it. Step-by-step procedure. Hope this was helpful. This is Mr. Frederick out.